हेलो एवरीवन, सो प्लीज टेल मी फर्स्ट वेदर एम आई क्लियरली ऑडिबल टू यू और नॉट, ओनली देन आई विल बिगिन विद द सेशन. सो आई कैन क्लियरली सी अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल, अ ह्यूज नंबर ऑफ पीपल आर वॉचिंग मी राइट नाउ. सो अ वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू गाइस. थैंक यू सो मच कौशिक फॉर मिसिंग मी. And thank you so much guys for coming to the session today. Now we are going to cover the spotlight of the month of December in this session, and as you know that success is the result of continuous efforts, and one of the continuous effort is the revision. So revision plays a key role in your preparation. So today we are going to revise the current affairs of the month of December. And in this session, I will be taking up 100 questions from the month of December. But do not forget that in the next part of December, just give us a second, guys. There is a technical glitch, so we need to resolve it. Just wait for 1 second. So one more second guys, we need some time to rectify the error, but you don't have to worry, this session is going to be really fruitful for you all. Okay, Tanvi ma'am beech mein kyon gaye? Dekho guys, success or growth to sabhi ko chahiye hoti hai, so Tanvi ma'am has gone for her growth as well, and I believe that you are the true student of hers, so please pray for her that she may succeed in her life. Okay, and right now we are working on another faculty, so probably you will have finance sessions coming up very soon. Okay guys, the very first thing that I am going to do today is that I am going to tell you how can you cover your Spotlight magazine effectively, because when I did the whole team of ours did the timetable session on 31st March, many students were asking me about how can they divide the Spotlight magazine in 15 days, okay, so that they can memorize the content better. So today I am going to tell you that only first. But before that guys, you still have time, okay? This is the starting of April month and you have May also, because your examination is on May 28th. So if you really want to crack the examination, you can just go for this course, you can check it out, and if you have your basics cleared, and even if you the basics are not cleared, this course is designed in such a manner that it will help you in clearing the examination, okay? So here is the new application that we have launched, and in this application you will get the daily current affairs, you will get the daily updates on the new videos that we upload on the YouTube. So all things are going to be provided at this one stop. So why wait for anything else? Just download this application after this session from the Play Store and explore the offerings that we are providing here for you all. So now, as I told you that I am going to first talk about the strategy to cover Spotlight effectively. So guys, you know that there are approximately 150 pages of content. I am talking about the content, I am not talking about the extra marketing pages or the questions or the answers, okay? So I am talking about the content from national news to the miscellaneous news, okay? So here you have approximately 150 pages. Just give me a second. 150 pages of Spotlight, okay, of 6 months. So if you multiply these pages, so you have cumulatively 900 pages to study. Now you have only 20 days to cover the Spotlight in one go. You need to do multiple revisions so that you can retain the facts more and more. And if you do want to do that, you need to complete the 900 pages of your Spotlight in 20 days, because only then you will get time for at least 3 revisions. Okay, so 900 pages ko if you divide by 20 days, then you have to cover 45 pages per day. So guys, this should be your target. Now let me read your comments first, because I can see that a lot of comments are here. So I'm just going to give 2-3 seconds and revise your see your comments, and then we will move on with the session. Amar Pathak is asking for the duration of this session. So Amar, I am going to cover 100 questions, and firstly I am going to talk about the strategy. So yes, the strategy is not complete yet, so don't think that it is complete. So I think that 1 hour 30 minutes would be there. Okay, so take it like that. Lamba session chalega thoda sa. Pratik, how can we upload the May Spotlight when the month is not here? Spotlight is the compilation of the current affairs. Month hi nahi aaya, toh Spotlight kaise aayegi? Sumit, Paul, we know that you all are missing Tanvi ma'am so seriously, but you don't have to worry about it. I'm going to convey this to Tanvi ma'am personally, that the students are really missing you here. But you don't have to worry about it, because your finance current affairs are definitely going to be covered. You will get the RBI 247 magazine, and surely we will come up with these sessions soon. Okay, I guess. Okay, so there are many questions pouring in. First, let me tell you that 6 months current affairs are important, and Nishant has asked me that whether you need to cover October or November current affairs also. So guys, in my opinion, if you haven't covered anything from the Spotlight, so do not go for October or November. 6 months are enough, so start from December and cover till May. Okay, and remember that the months just preceding the examination date, like the 4 months, are of utmost importance. Okay, from the 4 months, the examiner can ask you anything. Okay, so 4 months to bahut important hai, and 6 months ka aapko karna mandatory hai, par usse piche jaane ki I don't think that you need. Achha, Priyanka, you okay? So March Spotlight, guys, you will get in the coming week. No, Shri Hari Purushottam, this session is the revision session. So if you haven't prepared Spotlight, so I don't think that only doing this session will help you in cracking the phase one examination, because we are going to cover the session through the questions. Okay, we are not going to look into the news directly. So we will cover the aspects of the questions, we will cover the aspects of the news, but we are not going into depth of it. So for the depth, you need to study Spotlight once. Okay, so that's enough for your queries. Now I'm going to take up your queries towards the end of this session. Now let's move ahead with the session. So I have already told you how many pages do you need to cover in just one day. And guys, if you stay honest with you, if you stick to the plan, then only you will get at least three revisions of Spotlight. You will get the time to do revision of Spotlight 3 times. And remember, in current affairs, revision is the only and the last resort you can rely upon. So stick to the plan, 45 pages each day. And remember that you do not have to spend a lot of time on it. Okay, so check your time also and increase your speed, work on your speed. Okay, the next point or the next step that you can take to effectively memorize the Spotlight magazine is that you can cover the section cover the spotlight section wise. For example, today you have picked up national news section and miscellaneous section. Next day you pick up state news section and sports section. The next day you can pick up agriculture section and defense section. Now, why have I marked these two sections in pairs? So the reason behind this is that in the national news section, you have a lot of news. Okay, this is the gigantic section, you know, right? And in miscellaneous, you have a very few number of news, plus you have very few details attached to those news. So it will be easier for you to remember national news along with the miscellaneous news. So if you want to study in this manner, you can do so, but this is not the final rule. This is not the rigid rule. You can obviously keep it flexible in accordance with your preferences. Okay, whichever is the flexible way, you need to study in that manner. Okay, this is just the manner that I have told you. You can just prepare in this manner also. But if someone is there who needs to, who likes to study national news, who likes to study state news along with the national news, then he can also do that. But this is the way that I have carved out for you. Okay. So guys, this is another part of that strategy only. So whenever you cover the banking and economy section, I don't think that there is another section that you can pair up with it, because banking and economy is again a very huge section. A lot of news is there, and at the same time, it is of the utmost importance, because banking ka hi exam dene ja rahe hain, and banking and finance news are of utmost importance. So guys, that was the strategy. Now I am going to cover the questions. Okay, so the very first question that we have in front of us is, where is Kuzu Valley Bird Sanctuary located? So what is the right answer? Tell me the right answer. Till the time you guys tell me your right answer, let me tell you that Sheetal is asking me whether these classes are going to cover all the 6 months or not. So Sheetal, you can clearly see that we are beginning with the December current affairs, and from December onwards your 6 months start. So obviously I'm going to cover all the months. And remember, on May 26th we are going to have a Maha Marathon session where we will be covering all the 6 months current affairs in just one day. Okay, there will be 1,000 questions of current affairs and we are going to cover them. Okay, very good guys. A, Tamil Nadu is the right answer, and it is the 16th bird sanctuary of Tamil Nadu. Which committee prepared the designing the future of dispute resolution, the ODR policy plan for India report of Niti Aayog? So guys, which committee is it? So here the right answer is option E, AK Sikri committee. Guys, usually what we do is that I read the question and I ask for the answers from you. This time I'm thinking that I need to change my strategy a little bit. So what I have done is that from now onwards, from the third question onwards, I'm going to tell you the answer. You are going to tell me the associated facts related to that news. Or if I put it simply, why was this question in news? Okay, so the next question is, which of the following Indian organization has topped in the CIPRI's list of top 100 arms companies in 2020? So which Indian company is it? It is HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, and the global ranking of HAL was 42nd. Okay. देखो गाइस, किसी भी करंट अफेयर्स को करने का एक ही तरीका होता है. किसी भी ऐसे सब्जेक्ट को पढ़ने का तरीका जिसमें बहुत सारे फैक्ट्स हो, उसको पढ़ने का एक ही तरीका होता है, दैट यू डू कॉन्टिन्यूअस रिविजन्स. ओके, प्लस यू कैन ऑल्सो डू वन थिंग, यू कैन जस्ट प्रिपेयर निमोनिक्स इन योर माइंड, और यू कैन ऑल्सो एसोसिएट अ स्टोरी विद द न्यूज़. बट इट इज़ वेरी हार्ड टू डू इन वन लाइनर न्यूज़. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन योर अपॉइंटमेंट्स, इन योर इम्पॉर्टेंट डेज, इट इज़ वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू क्रिएट अ स्टोरी आउट ऑफ दैट न्यूज़. सो डोंट डू दैट. यू नीड टू क्रिएट द स्टोरी फॉर द न्यूज़ दैट नीड्स comprehension, that needs your cognitive skills. Okay, so for that, prepare the news, prepare the story on your own, or your mnemonics, whichever works for you the best. prepare that on your own, and whenever it comes to the one-liners like your appointments, important days, awards, then what you can do, what strategy you can apply to prepare that section, you can just do multiple revisions. And I have already told you that your target should be to cover 45 pages each day. And remember that you need to put a timer alongside you, because you cannot afford to spend a lot of time on Spotlight because you have English quant and reasoning as well. Okay, so this also should be subjective to each and every aspirant. If you are good in quant, reasoning and English, then you can definitely give more time to Spotlight. But if you are good in current affairs, if your memory power is that good, then you can give a less period of time to current affairs and spend more on quant, reasoning and English, because each and every section is going to have a sectional timing as well as a sectional cutoff. Okay, and this also reminds me that one student asked me that whether there would be a sectional cutoff also. So guys, yes, RBI notification has not said anything about it, but as per the norm, the sectional cutoff was there. Okay, so prepare your strategy, prepare yourself according to the norm. And we can see corrigendum coming up in 1 or 2 days, maybe. Okay, so that may clarify more things about it. Pooja, that depends upon the student. First ranker, Lockheed Martin. Very good. Pratishtha Singh. So guys, these kinds of facts I'm expecting from you all. I have already told you HAL and global rank of 42. What are the facts that I'm asking from you are the related facts, like which company has topped in this list overall. So it is Lockheed Martin of US, and US has majority of its defense manufacturing companies in the top 100 arms companies list. Moving ahead, which bank has announced to buy a 9% stake in Open Network for Digital Commerce? Now guys, pay attention to the word announced. So it is, guys, Punjab National Bank. So it has announced in the month of December that it is going to buy a 9% stake in Open Network for Digital Commerce. But here is a twist. Please listen to me carefully. The twist is that 6% stake has been bought by Punjab National Bank recently. It is not 9% now. This was the announcement made in December, and 6% acquisition has been made in March. So what is the latest percentage? It is 6%. I'm again repeating, 6%. Punjab National Bank's share in ONDC is 6%. Which bank has signed an agreement with Usha International Limited for empowering women entrepreneurs by providing financial assistance? Okay, so which bank is it? So guys, the right answer is State Bank of India. Now quickly tell me the name of the initiative, or basically, if I put it simply, so Usha International Limited and State Bank of India, both of these organizations have collaborated, and they have given a certain name to their collaboration or the initiatives that they are going to take for the women empowerment. So name the initiative. Okay, I got it that you all know that it is SBI plus. Very good. So who has given me this answer? Nitish. Nav Chetna, absolutely right. Please remember, Nav Chetna is the collaboration between SBI and Usha International Limited. For which state has India signed a loan agreement with Asian Development Bank for improving the drinking water supply and citywide inclusive sanitation services? So let me tell you, it is Uttarakhand. Now I'm going to ask you the cities for which Uttarakhand has taken this loan. Tell me the name of the cities. No, Nilesh, it's not Punjab, it's Uttarakhand. I know that Asian Development Bank gives a lot of loans to different states in India. Therefore, it becomes a little perilous for you all to memorize the loans given by ADB. But what can you do here? You can prepare a list of loans specifically given by ADB to different states. Okay, so in that list, you can just mention ADB loans as the heading, and on the one side, you can mention the list of the states that have taken loans from the Asian Development Bank, and on the other hand of the page, you can write the reason for which they have taken the loan and also make space for the amount of the loan. Okay, Dehradun and Nainital, absolutely right, $125 million. worth of loan was taken. Which international organization conducted the cyber drill 2021 with the Department of Telecommunication for Indian entities? So guys, what is the right answer? The right answer here is International Telecommunication Union. Now, it is basically headquartered in Geneva, Switzerland, and at present this organization has 193 member states. Also remember, the purpose of this cyber drill was to equip the government officials with the cyber security measures. Who among the following is not a member of the EWS review panel? A very, very crucial question from your exam point of view. So please tell me what is the right answer here. Who is not a member? Not is here. So guys, this EWS review panel is a 3-member panel created by the central government to review the EWS criteria that has been given for the general category. Okay, so here Arvind Singh is the right answer. So Ajay Bhushan Pandey, VK Malhotra, Sanjeev Sanyal, all of these 3 people are part of this panel. And remember, in RBI Grade B notification of 2022, EWS category people are not getting any kind of extra benefit also. Okay, so if you belong to the EWS category, so there is no age relaxation for you, there is no educational qualification relaxation for you, and other kinds of perks are not there for you. Okay, it's just that your seats are reserved in RBI. So that is the benefit that you are getting. And one more thing that I want to clarify here for the students, that is that guys, EWS certificate ki date is not required. It is not mandatory for you to have EWS certificate of the latest date. Okay, however, it is preferable if you have the latest EWS certificate of 2021 to 2022, then it would be beneficial, or 2020 to 2021. Okay, because FY22 has just completed, and if you have issued your certificate after March 28th, then it would be invalid from RBI's point of view. So it would be preferable if you have FY21 financial years EWS certificate. But even if you have FY20's certificate, then also it is applicable. So don't get any kind of confusion here. Yes, 10% was the reservation. Which state has been picked up as the most friendly state for film shooting at the 52nd IFFI? Okay, India's International Film Festival. So guys, here the right answer is option A, Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh has got this award. What is the criteria for assessing large dams under the Dam Safety Bill 2019? Now remember that the Dam Safety Bill, or actually the Act, has been passed by the Parliament and it has actually become an Act. So it is the Dam Safety Act 2021. Now the criteria or the thresholds that are mentioned in the bill have been endorsed by the Parliament. Has been endorsed by the Parliament in the Act also. Okay, so here what is the right answer? It is 15 meters. So all the dams who are of 15 meter are eligible for assessment under the Dam Safety Act 2021. Which of the following states has organized the 9th edition of International Tourism Mart for the Northeast region for the first time? So guys, here Kohima, Nagaland is the right answer. Nagaland is the state, Kohima is the venue. Which state has won the gold award at the 40th edition of India International Trade Fair for its pavilion? So guys, here the gold award has been given to Bihar. Your task is to tell me which state has got the silver and bronze award for their pavilion at the India International Trade Fair. Now guys, let me tell you that Bihar was the partner state of this India International Trade Fair. Okay, so it helped in organizing this festival, and Jharkhand and Uttar Pradesh were the focus states. These are also some of the facts that may be asked from you in the examination. Very good. Assam's pavilion has won the silver award and Kerala's pavilion has won the bronze awards. However, it is really anomalous that Kerala, who stands out in most of the socio-economic factors or indices, has got the bronze award in this India International Trade Fairs Pavilion, and Bihar, which always remains at the lowest position, has got the gold award. So in this manner, you can better memorize this award. Okay. What is the outlay of scheme for investment promotion for 5 years? So recently this scheme has got extension. So what is the outlay of this scheme? Now guys, the right answer here is rupees 970 crores. Okay. Tell me the year in which this scheme was launched. Now guys, let me also tell you, the Department of Promotion for Internal Industry and Internal Trade, DPIIT, is the nodal agency for the implementation of this scheme, which primarily aims to promote investment in India. Okay, one person said 2019, then there is 2016. 2008 is also in the options. So here guys, 2008 is the right answer, not 19 or 16. Please memorize this thing. 2008 was the year in which this scheme was launched. With which state has Walmart and its subsidiary Flipkart signed an MOU for training MSMEs to digitize their business and sell their products online? So guys, the right answer here is Madhya Pradesh. Okay, Madhya Pradesh, Walmart and Flipkart. All these three organizations have collaborated, and the initiative under which Walmart is providing the training is the Walmart Vriddhi initiative. Okay. Which country hosted the 5th Indian Ocean Conference? Okay. So here guys, UAE is the right answer. Abu Dhabi is the place where this conference was held in UAE. Okay. Tell me the theme of this conference, 5th India Ocean Conference. And as you would know that nowadays the questions are not generally asked about the venues, because venues are easy for the people to remember. Rather, the examiner tends to ask difficult things that are too much in depth. So tell me the theme of this Indian Ocean Conference. Very good. Mukul Sagar has given the theme economy, ecology and epidemic. Okay, Indian Ocean: economy, ecology and epidemic is the theme. Okay. Which is the most expensive city in the world as per EIU's worldwide cost of living 2021 index? Tel Aviv. Very good. Tel Aviv is a city in Israel. So Israel mein ye city hai, and it is the world's most expensive city. Which is the world's least expensive city? Or rather, I should ask you, which is India's least expensive city? Because the world's least expensive city is Damascus, which is the capital of Syria. So it is really easy to remember it, because Damascus, or rather the entire country of Syria, is always war trodden. Okay, so nobody is willing to go there, to visit there. Then obviously the hotels and everything there is very cheap. But which is India's least expensive city? This would rather become a question in your examination, and I am getting the answers. So one person is saying Mumbai. How can Mumbai be the least expensive city? No, it's Ahmedabad. What is the projection for FY22 global trade in value terms by the UNCTAD's Global Trade Outlook Report of November 2021? Now guys, we tend to see the projections for the GDP, but there are trade projections as well. Okay, the trade outlook is also provided by UNCTAD, so this is also important. Go through this report thoroughly from the December 2021 spotlight, and you can download the spotlight from our website. The link of that is given in the description. Okay, so if you face any kind of problem in downloading the spotlight, then you can just dial the number that is there on our website. Okay, then you will be connected with our executive and you can talk to them if you find any kind of problem in downloading the spotlight or in navigating through the website. Very good. 28 trillion US dollar would be the is the trade outlook, okay, the projection for the trade outlook. When is the BSF Raising Day celebrated? So guys, Raising Day of the Armed Forces of India are of utmost importance. One question we have already seen in previous year's examination, that is DRDO's Establishment Day. Okay, so now what is the BSF's Raising Day? Tell me the date. So guys, the right answer here is December 1st. Now, can you guys tell me the venue where the celebrations of this date took place in 2021? Venue of the day. And let me tell you that the motto of BSF's Raising Day is duty unto death. Okay, this is the motto. Tell me the place where the celebrations of this day took place. Very good, very good. So Pratishtha and Apurva both have given the answers. It is Jaisalmer, and duty unto death is the motto of BSF. Okay, so guys, whenever you come across any military force, okay, please remember the motto of that force. Even if it is not given in the magazine of current affairs, go and search for it. Okay. Next question is, who has won the 7th Dr. M.S. Swaminathan Award for the period 2017-19? So guys, what is the right answer? The right answer is option C. V. Praveen Rao has won this award. Now, M.S. Swaminathan is a very prominent name in the field of agriculture. So, he is known as the mastermind behind the Green Revolution. How much is the proposed outlay of residential education for students in high schools in targeted areas scheme, which is also acronymed as Shrestha scheme? Now, guys, let me tell you that this scheme has not been launched yet. Okay. The Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment is still working upon this scheme. And the purpose of this scheme is to provide high quality education, high quality school education to the scheduled caste students. Okay. That may have the residential facilities as well. Now, what is the proposed outlay of this scheme? Tell me that. 300 crores. Absolutely right. Okay, when was the Digi Yatra policy operationalized? So there is a really tricky point here in terms of the introduction of the policy and the implementation of the policy. So both of the years are different. 2018 was the year in which this policy was announced, or rather introduced. But 2019 was the year in which this policy was operationalized. And clearly, Digi Yatra is to digitize the tourism, travel and tourism in India. Okay, all the workload and all the activities that you need to do, like booking the hotels, like verifying your certificates, everything should be done online. Where was the 5th International Ambedkar Conclave organized? So clearly, the right answer here is New Delhi. Do remember the edition of this conclave, because there is nothing else to memorize from this news. So if the examiner was in the mood to prepare a question from it, then the examiner may ask you about the edition. Which state has received US dollar 135 million loan from the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development for upgrading its rural power distribution network? So guys, as you would know that IBRD is a part of the World Bank Group, and it gives the development loans for the development of the developing nations. Okay, Raj, till the time you give your answers, I tell you the associated facts, right? Because if I give you more time than this, then the session would extend to 2 hours, and then you will also tell me that, ma'am, please wind up the session soon. Okay, West Bengal is the right answer. Okay, West Bengal is also the state that has also taken loan to provide the social benefits to the people, okay, to fulfill its obligation under the social welfare schemes. What is IFCO's rank in the 10th annual World Cooperative Monitor 2021 report? So guys, लेट मी टेल यू दैट इफको इज द कंपनी, इट इज इंडियन कंपनी एंड इट इज द वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट कंपनी, और वी शुड से इट इज द कंपनी दैट हैज डेवलप्ड वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट नैनो यूरिया लिक्विड. ओके, नाउ नैनो यूरिया लिक्विड इज रियली सस्टेनेबल इन नेचर बिकॉज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इन इट्स प्रोडक्शन स्टेज देर इज नो यूज ऑफ एनर्जी कंजम्पशन. वी कैन से द एनर्जी कंजम्पशन इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ नैनो यूरिया लिक्विड इज रियली लो. सो इन दैट मैनर इट इज सस्टेनेबल. एंड सेकेंडली, यूरिया इज वेरी वाइडली यूज बाई द फार्मर्स इन इंडिया. And the urea that the farmers use are in terms of granules. Okay, the chote chote granules hote hain urea ke, that is used by the farmers. And this nano urea is very smaller in size. Therefore, it would reduce the waste that is generated from the urea granules that farmers use. Okay, so in this manner, it is very sustainable in nature. And at the same time, it will increase the productivity of the land. Divya, I prepare the questions according to the exam pattern. So you may expect questions on the similar line. I'm not saying that the examiner would pick up the question directly from the spotlight. That obviously is not going to happen. But you can expect the same level, the same manner in which the questions are prepared in your spotlight. I hope that I have answered the question. First, yes, IFCO's rank is first in this World Cooperative Monitor report as well. Which bank has launched the Mahila Mitra Plus facility? So obviously such kind of facilities are launched by many banks nowadays for women, for MSMEs, for the downtrodden sections of the society. So this is one of the initiatives. Now, which bank has launched it? So guys, it is Federal Bank. Okay. Which organization has signed an MOU with the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship to train 6,000 individuals over a period of 3 years in the rapidly growing fintech industry? So guys, it is Paytm. Now regarding Paytm, let me tell you that it is also a scheduled commercial bank. Okay, Paytm's payment bank is a scheduled commercial bank in India. What is OECD's forecast for India for FY23? Okay, for the coming year, what is the forecast, GDP forecast provided by OECD? So guys, the right answer here is 8.1. Now 5.5% has been forecasted for the year ahead of us, that is FY24. Okay, and 9.4% is the forecast for FY22 by OECD. Okay, I would recommend you to prepare all the GDP forecast towards the end of your preparation. Like whenever your exam is very near, your exam is on May 28th. So I would recommend you that prepare the GDP forecast just 1 week before your examination, because in the meantime, it can change. Next question is, who has been appointed as the UNESCO Goodwill Ambassador for Cultural and Cooperative Industries? So let me tell you, the person is from Japan. Japan's film producer hai ye jinko appoint kiya gaya hai as UNESCO's Goodwill Ambassador for Cultural and Creative Industry. So which person is this? Naomi. Very good. Option B, guys, is the right answer. Who has been appointed as the next Deputy Managing Director of IMF? So it is Geeta Gopinath. Till which year has the Smart Cities Mission been extended? I hope that you all know that 100 cities are going to be converted into smart cities. Now, by which year or till which year this mission has been extended? 2023, absolutely right. 2023 is the right answer. When was the Northeastern State Roads Investment Program launched? So guys, let me tell you that this program was launched in collaboration with Asian Development Bank. Okay, and the basic purpose is very evidently conveyed from its name itself, that is the development of the state's roads, the Northeastern State's roads. Now, in which year was this launched? Very good, guys. 2011. Option B is the right answer. Which Indian city will be connected to Akura, Bangladesh via railways? So guys, it is Agartala. Agartala will be connected, the capital of Tripura. Which state has the largest area under rubber cultivation in the northeast India? Okay, so there is also a news recently that Kerala has outperformed the northeastern states in terms of rubber cultivation. So there is a really, we can say, a deadlock, or we can say a really tough competition between Kerala and the northeastern states, particularly in the field of rubber cultivation. Okay, so which state is the largest producer, or we can say which state has the largest area under the rubber cultivation? So it is Tripura. Okay, option A is the right answer. Tripura has the largest area. Which of the following initiatives has been launched by the National Cadet Corps to free seashores beaches from plastic and other waste materials and increase awareness about importance of keeping the beaches clean? So you have the five options in front of you. Tell me the right answer. Yes, overall it is Kerala. And Tripura is really trying hard, and other northeastern states are also trying hard to increase their production of agriculture, okay, in different crops. Puneet Sagar Abhiyan is the right answer. How much is the center's share in the centrally sponsored scheme for development of infrastructure facilities for judiciary? So guys, what is the total share of the central government? Let me tell you that 9000 crore is the total budget of this scheme, okay, and you have to tell me the share of the central government. Very good. 5307 is the share of the central government, and 9000 crore is the total budget of this scheme. Now guys, why was the scheme in the news particularly? Because the CGI of India, that is N.V. Ramana, has proposed to create the National Infrastructure Authority for the judicial infrastructure. This authority would be created under the CGI of India, and the basic purpose of this authority would be to upgrade the infrastructure of the courts in India. So that is why this scheme was in the news again. And remember that the proposal for creating this authority has not been passed by the government yet. It is just in the proposal stage only. Which PSU company has signed an MOU with Solar Energy Corporation of India to fulfill its green energy commitments of producing a minimum of 10 gigawatt of renewable power by 2040? Very good. ONGC guys is the right answer. Which country will get world's first floating city by 2025? Very good. South Korea. Which company has launched India's first ever Nifty Alpha 50 ETF, that is exchange traded fund? So which company has launched it? Guys, it is Kotak Mahindra Mutual Fund. Who has been appointed as a chairman of National Asset Reconstruction Company? So guys, when this news was there in December month, Pradeep Shah was appointed as the chairman. But right now, as we are covering this in April month, recently we have got the news that Pradeep Shah has resigned as the chairman of this company, and Subrata Biswas, who is working in SBI, has been appointed as the interim chairperson of this National Asset Reconstruction Company, which is popularly known as the Bad Bank of India. Okay, so now who is the interim chairperson of this organization? It is Subrata Biswas and not Pradeep Shah. I'm again repeating, Subrata Biswas, who works in SBI, he is the interim chairperson, not the full-time chairperson. Interim appoint kiya gaya. Next question is, which of the following exercises is conducted by India with Maldives? So here, Equivalent is the right answer. Which state is the manufacturing hub of India as per RBI's Handbook of Statistics on Indian States 2021? So manufacturing hub of India, which state is it? as per RBI, RBI's Handbook of Statistics on India's rule. So guys, it is Gujarat. Now, Gujarat has replaced Maharashtra in terms of manufacturing, but Maharashtra still remains at the top position in terms of services. Okay, so in terms of services, Maharashtra is the first, and in terms of manufacturing, Gujarat is the first. Okay, do remember this thing. What is the theme of the World Soil Day? So we celebrate the Soil Day on December 5th. Now, what is the theme of this day? You have to tell that. You can also mention the option, right? So here the right answer is option E. Halt soil salination, boost soil productivity. Recently, Victor Axelsen has won the BWF Male Player of the Year 2021 award. Which country does he belong to? So I guess it has now become a very cliche question, because Victor Axelsen is one personality that remains in the news very often because of his fiats in badminton. So he belongs to Denmark. Can you guys tell me that who has won the BWF Women Player of the Year 2021 award? I have told you Denmark is the answer. Tell me women who has won this. So guys, the right answer is Tai Zhu Ying. So Tai se Taiwan. Ye aap yaad rakhna. Tai Zhu Ying belongs to Taiwan. And she has won the BWF Women Player of the Year 2021. Recently, Russia has won the Davis Cup 2021, which was held in Austria, Spain and Italy. In which sport is the Davis Cup trophy given? So guys, what is the right answer here? So here guys, tennis is the right answer. Okay. Now remember that Women Tennis Association is the organization that regulates the women's tennis tournaments, and ATP, Association of Tennis Professionals, regulates the tennis profession or the tennis tournaments created for men's. Who has won the BWF World Badminton Tour 2021 medal from India? So guys, this was the tournament in badminton, and the medal from India has been won by PV Sindhu. Okay, now tell me, because she has won the silver medal in this tournament, so who has won the gold medal, or who has become the winner of this BWF World Badminton Tour 2021 in women's single category? PV Sindhu has won the silver medal here. And also, one more interesting fact about PV Sindhu is that she was the first woman who has won silver medal in Olympics. Also, she is the first Indian to win silver in Olympics. Again, she is the first person or woman or Indian to win silver medal in badminton in Olympics. Okay, so all of these first are attached to PV Sindhu. Very good. An Se-young, and she belongs to South Korea. So she has won the women's singles, and men's singles is again Victor Axelsen, he has won that. Now guys, can you tell me that in which year's Olympics did PV Sindhu win her first silver medal? Yes, she has two Olympic medals now. Latest one to inhone apna Tokyo Olympics mein hi jeeta tha. Tell me, in which year or in which Olympic did she win her silver medal? Okay, so this question guys is the very easy question. Whose death anniversary is observed as Mahaparinirvan Divas in India? So it is B.R. Ambedkar, and we know that he, along with his many followers, converted to Buddhism. So Mahaparinirvan Divas is also the day on which Mahavir Buddha died. Okay, so in relation to that also, B.R. Ambedkar's death anniversary is called Mahaparinirvana Divas. What is the theme of International Civil Aviation Day 2021? So guys, the theme is Advancing Innovation for Global Aviation Development. So I guess someone has written 2017 as well. So Harshit, Olympics are always conducted after 4 years. So in fourth table, you can memorize it in this manner, that in fourth table it is conducted. So obviously 2017 cannot be the year in which any Olympics was organized. It is 2016 Rio Olympics, in which PV Sindhu won her first medal. Okay, when do we celebrate the International Civil Aviation Day? So guys, it is December 7. December 7 is the date. Who has been appointed as a chairman of Inland Waterways Authority of India? So tell me the right answer here. What is the right answer? It is Sanjay Bandyopadhyay. Who is the author of 1971 Charge of the Gorkhas and Other Stories book? So guys, here Rachna Bhist Rawat is the right answer. Which of the following countries is not, again, not among the partner countries of India in the Infinity Forum on FinTech? Let me tell you that this Infinity Forum was organized by the IFSCA, that is International Financial Services Centers Authority, which regulates the International Financial Services Center, which is located in Gift City in Gandhinagar. Okay, so that organization, IFSCA, has organized this Infinity Forum on FinTech in order to have more and more ideas regarding the FinTech technology. Okay, and the organization that has partnered with IFSCA in organizing this forum is Bloomberg. So do remember, Bloomberg has collaborated. Now tell me the country which has not collaborated with IFSCA in this Infinity Forum. So right here is Denmark, which is the right answer. So South Africa, Indonesia and UK, all these three countries collaborated with India for this Infinity Forum. Do remember. MPay Delight application is the mobile app of which bank? So guys, here Jammu and Kashmir is the right answer. The head of this bank is RK Chibber. Do remember. Now, how can you memorize it better? You can memorize it in this manner also, that after reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir, or after the abrogation of Article 370, the people got delighted. Therefore, the bank launched the MPay Delight application. However, this entire statement has nothing to do with the actual mindset of the people who are living in Jammu and Kashmir, but it is just a way for us to memorize this news better. Okay. Next is, where has the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship launched pilot project for reviving the Namra craft? Very good. Jammu and Kashmir, guys, is the right answer here. Who has been appointed as the chairperson of National Highway Authority of India? Yes, Alka Upadhyay is the right answer. National Highways Authority of India. Which country has won the gold medal at the FIH Men's Junior Hockey World Cup 2021 held in Bhubaneswar, Odisha? So guys, here the right answer is Argentina. It has won the gold medal. Who is the author of the Midway Battle, Modi's Roller Coaster Second Term book? So this is the name of the book. Who has written this book? So guys, the person who has did a lot of chinta on Modi's roller coaster second term is the person who has written this book. So who is the person who has chinta in his name? It is Gautam Chintamani. So you can memorize it in this manner. Okay, chinta kar karke ye kitab likh di Modi ke upar and Modi ji ke upar, and now he is in the question. Who is the chairperson of scale committee of the government? So who is the right what is the right answer here? So guys, option B, Pavan Goenka is the right answer. So he is the CMD, Chairman and Managing Director of Hindustan Unilever Limited, and he is the chairperson of the scale committee, which has a strength of total 14 members. Can you guys tell me the full form of scale? Tell me the full form of scale. Basically, this committee aims to boost the production, the local manufacturing in India. Dalmai is not the right answer now because he was earlier. Now, Pavan Goenka is the chairperson. Guys, tell me the full form of scale committee, okay? In the meantime, why not we discuss the next question? How many institutes will be given the status of institute of national importance under the National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research Amendment Bill 2021? Now, guys, I hope that you know that whenever there is a bill on an organization, that organization becomes a statutory organization, okay? Because there is a statute there for the establishment and the regulation of that organization. So, obviously, the National Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research are the statutory bodies. Yes, steering committee for local value addition and your exports. Okay, your is not there in the full form, obviously. Guys, here the right answer is 6. Total 6 NIPAR organizations or institutes will be given the national importance status. Name the exercise to be conducted by BIMSTEC to foster joint planning and build regional cooperation for responding to natural disasters. What is the right answer? The right answer is PENEX. How can you memorize it effectively? So guys, PENEX was conducted to increase the response to the pandemic, or you can say the response to the natural disasters. And whenever there is a natural disaster, we tend to get panic. So from panic, PENEX, because both of these sound very similar in nature. So PENEX, PENEX, okay? So in this manner, you can memorize that BIMSTEC organized this PENEX exercise to boost its interoperability and its response time towards natural disaster. Who has been appointed as the president of Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry? FICCI ke chairperson kaun hai? So it is Sanjeev Mehta right now. Can you tell me that with which company is Sanjeev Mehta related to? Okay, so let me make one thing clear here. Pavan Goenka, guys. Is the former CEO of Mahindra. Okay, do remember this thing. And Sanjeev Mehta is the current CMD of Hindustan Unilever Limited. So that was a mistake. Okay, now I'm rectifying my mistake. So please pay attention to this thing that Pavan Goenka is the former CEO of Mahindra and CMD of HUL is Sanjeev Mehta. Okay. With which institute has NCW, National Commission for Women, partnered for its She is a Changemaker program? So guys, here the right answer is option D, RMP Thane, which is a very local organization in Maharashtra, and it has partnered with NCW for this She is a Changemaker program. Recent news related to NCW is that it has launched the legal clinics, legal aid clinics. Okay, I have. Can you guys tell me that in which state or union territory has National Commission for Women launched these legal aid clinics for women particularly that aims to provide free legal services or consultation to women who are in distress? In which state or union territory? Tell me the answer. Very good. Pooja, Priya, I'm really impressed by you guys because you gave the answer very quickly. So Delhi is the right answer. Now Aishana Bansal has also given a really important insight to all of us. That is, the chairperson of this NCW is Rekha Sharma. Next question is, when was the Air Suvidha Portal launched? So guys, you can clearly associate the launching of this portal with the COVID pandemic, because when COVID came, when COVID knocked on our doors, we had to get inside the house. Okay, everything became online, and online meetings, online work, online filling of the forms, everything became the norm of the day. Okay, so obviously, when Air Suvidha Portal was launched, the purpose of this portal was to provide facility or provide help to the travelers who are coming from abroad or who are going outside in their COVID vaccination certificate. Okay, they can upload their certificate so that they don't have to waste time at the airport in re-verifying them. Okay, so that is the basic purpose. So clearly, the answer is August 2020, because that's the year in which COVID was there or came in India. Still, COVID is here, so please stay protected and use mask. Even though in Delhi we are not mandatory to use mask because now the fine is not there, but that does not mean that we can be careless with ourselves, and particularly you guys, because you have your exam coming up, and because of just one carelessness, you cannot afford to miss your one attempt. Okay, so don't do that with yourself. Take precautions and stay healthy. Do exercises regularly. We tend to think that only mental exercises will sharpen our mind, but that is not the case. You must have heard that sound mind resides in a sound body. So your body needs to be sound. For that, you need to do exercise. So do exercise. Give 15-20 minutes to yourself, to your body. Okay? Chaliye, that was the motivation. Now let's back to the studies. So, which Indian state has received $150 million loan from Asian Development Bank for developing inclusive, resilient, sustainable housing for the urban poor? So, again, a loan from the Asian Development Bank. So, which state is it? So guys, here Tamil Nadu is the right answer. I told you now that you need to prepare a list. Okay, you can just keep one paper, and on that paper what you can do, write ADB loans to India as your heading. Theek hai, make three columns. Write the name of the states like UP, Tamil Nadu, etc. etc. Write the purpose for which the loan, like the urban cities or etc. etc. What is the purpose? And also write the amount, because now amounts are also asked by RBI and NABARD and SEBI and अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके, बिकॉज अब कुछ बचा ही नहीं है उनके पास पूछने के लिए, क्योंकि जो भी मेन फैक्ट्स है वो तो सारे स्टूडेंट्स करके आ रहे हैं. सो दे नीड टू स्किम द क्रीम फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द क्राउड. सो फॉर दैट दे आर आस्किंग द अमाउंट्स एज वेल. वेरी रैंडम क्वेश्चन आर देयर इन द एग्जाम. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव हियर इज, रिसेंटली DRDO has developed and tested the vertical launch short range surface to air missile from integrated test range in Chandipur off the Odisha coast. Which missile is the design of VLSR SAM based on? Basically, this equipment is based on the design of which missile? So guys, Astra is the right answer. So I have got the right answers already. Which country accounts for the highest estimated cases of malaria in the Southeast Asia region as per WHO's World Malaria Report 2021? So guys, clearly India is the right answer. India is not only the largest country in South Asia and in the Southeast Asian region, if we keep Indonesia aside, okay, because that's the largest archipelago in the world. Okay, so apart from that, in terms of economy or in every other sense, India is the largest developing country in the South Asia region, of course, and one of the largest countries in the Southeast Asian region. Okay, now obviously India is not in the Southeast Asia, but we are comparing here, okay? So now in terms of malaria also, the highest burden of malaria is also on India. And in terms of malarial deaths also, India is having the largest share, okay? Now guys, can you tell me that in high burden to high impact initiative of WHO, of which India is also a part, can you tell me in how many countries is WHO running this program to reduce the number of malaria, to reduce the impact of malaria? High burden to high impact countries. How many countries are there? Tell me that. Yes, highest burden of TB also is there in India, and both malaria and TB are curable diseases. Okay, there are vaccines for that, and still we are not able to save the lives of the people just because we do not have proper access of medicines. Very good. Total 11 countries are there, and these 11 countries have the world's highest burden of malaria. As per WHO's Global Technical Strategy for Malaria 2016 to 2013, global malaria mortality rates are reduced by -% by 2030, are to be reduced by -% by 2030. So basically, what is the target in terms of global malaria mortality rates reduction set by WHO? So guys, here the right answer is 90%. So mortalities should be reduced by 90%. My question from you all is, tell me the base year from where the WHO is going to compare its performance in 2030. I guess I have asked you a really tricky question right now. Let's see how many of you get it right. The base year from which the WHO is going to compare its performance to. So Akshita Rawat has given the right answer, and Akshita, I must say you have impressed me. So Rajesh Mishra, Pratishtha Singh, all of you guys are doing really good. And I'm not saying that the people who have not given the answers to me right now because they were typing the answer, they are not doing any good. I'm just saying that these people have given me the answer, so I'm impressed with their preparation. Okay. Next question is, which bank has launched India's first loan facility against digital gold? All the people who are saying 2015 as the base year, you guys are absolutely right. And I must say your preparation is also going in the right direction. Anusha, it's not 2002, it's 2015. Vishal, we are planning to give you all the 6 months one-liners cumulatively on 1st May. Okay, Shivalik is the right answer. Very good. Shivalik Small Finance Bank has given that. Which company has received approval for supporting the tokenization of RuPay cards? Okay, so tokenization is one initiative that RBI is hell-bent on implementing on the Indian banking system. So here is a company that has come in the forefront, and it has got approval for tokenizing the RuPay cards. So that is, guys, a really big achievement. So what is the right answer? No, it's PayFee, not PayPal. PayFee is the right answer. Who is the present Secretary General of International Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance? IDEA. So guys, let me tell you that this institute is located in Sweden. The headquarters of this institution is located in Sweden, which is an equally important question. And the total strength of the board of this organization is 15 members. Okay. Now tell me the Secretary General. It is Sunil Arora, the former Chief Election Commissioner of India. Who is the present Chief Election Commissioner? Tell me the name. Which country has assumed the vice chairmanship of the Global Methane Initiative's steering committee along with India? Okay, so this Global Methane Initiative aims to reduce the production of methane or emission of methane. That is the primary objective for which this Global Methane Initiative was launched. Very good, guys. Sushil Chandra is the present Chief Election Commissioner of India. Secretary General is Sunil Arora. Okay, he has been appointed as a Secretary General. USA has got the vice chairmanship of this organization, of this chairing body of this organization. Okay, so here we are getting the replies from, there is one person who has given the right answer here. So guys, there is a mistake. It's not Sunil Arora, it's Kevin Cassis Zamora. Option D is the right answer. So give me a second. I don't know why my laptop is hanging. Give me a second. Yes, the Secretary General of this steering board of this organization is Kevin Cassis Zamora, and Sunil Arora has joined this organization as a member. Member ki tarah inhone join kiya, and he is not the Secretary General. Okay, so that was a mistake. Please rectify this mistake. It is Kevin Cassis. So the person who has given me the right answer, thank you so much. Okay, what is the female labor force participation ratio in India as per World Inequalities Report 2022? Absolutely right. And the average of Asia, what is the Asia's average in terms of female labor force participation ratio? It is 21%. So India has a lower participation ratio in comparison to the average of Asia. What is India's score in the Asia Power Index 2021? And obviously USA is the country that holds the first position in this index. Okay, now what is the score of India? So guys, the right answer is 37.7. What is the ranking of India? It is 4th. And USA holds the first rank. Which of the following entity is partnering with Niti Aayog's E-Sawari India Electric Bus Coalition? So obviously, the basic purpose of this coalition is to promote the electric vehicles, the public transportation, okay? Electrified public transportation. So which organization is collaborating with Niti Aayog for this initiative? Very good. Only A and B. So guys, there is a third organization as well that is partnering for this coalition. Can you tell me the name of that third organization? Obviously, Rocky Mountain Institute is not that organization. So which is it? The name of that organization. So guys, the right answer to the question is Transform Urban Mobility Initiative. Okay, that is the third organization that is partnering with E-Sawari India Electric Bus Coalition. Who has won the 57th Gyanpeeth Award for the year 2021? Option A is the right answer. Damodar Mauzo is the right answer, and he is a Konkani writer. So from in Konkani language he writes. Which bank has launched the Rupee on the Go service during the Digital Payments Utsav? First of all, tell me which ministry organized this Digital Payment Utsav. The ministry which organized it. Tell me the name of the ministry. Very good. City Union Bank is the right answer. So guys, which ministry organized this? Very good. Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Where was the 6th edition of India Water Impact Summit held? So guys, option A, IIT Kanpur is the right answer. With which airline has CSIR, Indian Institute of Petroleum, partnered to manufacture and deploy sustainable aviation fuel globally? Okay, so tell me the right answer. So Indigo guys is the right answer. Very good. Which of the following missions will be sent by NASA to study the origins of solar energetic particles? So here UVSC Pathfinder is the right answer. What is the new UPI limit for retail investors who want to invest in IPO and RBI Retail Direct Scheme? Again, a very important question. Now, RBI Retail Direct Scheme was launched to allow the retail investors to invest in the government securities. Okay, so this scheme is again very important. Do remember this scheme as well. Now, what is the new UPI limit for that? So now it is 5 lakhs. Earlier it was 2 lakh rupees. Now it has been enhanced to rupees 5 lakh. Recently, Byju's, the world's most valuable edtech company, has acquired GeoGebra, an interactive geometry, algebra, statistics, calculus application for students. Where is the GeoGebra headquartered? So obviously it is not an Indian company. Now Byju's is really expanding its base, it is expanding its business, and in order to expand its business in the Middle East and North African region, it has partnered with the Qatar Investment Agency as well to expand its business in the Middle East initially in the first phase. Then also it will definitely expand to the adjacent areas. Now where is this GeoGebra headquartered? So it is Austria. How many rivers are connected under this Sariyu Canal National Project? Again, a very important project. Five, absolutely. Can you guys name all the five rivers that are going to be connected under the Sariyu Canal National Project? Tell me the names of the rivers. Under which scheme has India received $350 million loan from Asian Development Bank to improve its urban services? So now here pay attention to the fact that this loan has been given to the government of India, not any one single state. Plus it has been given for one of the central schemes. Okay, so which scheme is it? It is again a very important question. So Ghagra, Rapti, Banganga, Sarayu, Rohini. Shwetank Patel, Patel, sorry, absolutely right. You have given all the five rivers, and guys, whoever is watching me right now, please pay attention to this comment. Ghagra, Rapti, Banganga, Sarayu and Rohini. These are the five rivers that are going to be connected under the Sarayu Canal National Project. So here, what is the right answer? Very good. Amrut and Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Which state has launched the milk price incentive scheme? So guys, it is Uttarakhand, because in Uttarakhand the milk production is really low. So what are they going to do? They are going to incentivize the milk farmers, milk producers. Okay, so that is the basic scheme all about. Which city has announced its plan to become a sponge city to adopt innovative water management strategies to curb the urban flooding? So what is the basic meaning of a sponge city? So basically the roads in the city are made with such a material that they can absorb a lot of water in just 1 or 2 seconds. So in seconds, a lot of water quantity is absorbed by the road. So that is the concept of sponge city. Okay, so in this manner, the infrastructure of the city, or particularly the roads, will be created in a manner of a sponge. Like the sponge absorbs the water, similarly the roads would be able to absorb the water. Right now we have these kinds of roads in very developed nations like USA. Chennai, absolutely. Chennai is taking a lot of initiatives to curb the urban flooding. Okay, what is the theme of the 2022 G20 summit? So it is Indonesia that is hosting this summit. And also remember this fact that right now Indonesia is in a fix. It is having a lot of pressure from the Western countries, because right now the world is planning to ban Russia from the G20, and because Indonesia is the present president of the G20, therefore a lot of pressure is being put on Indonesia. And India is fortunate right now. Luckily, India got saved from this kind of a situation, because at present also, even though we are not at the helm of this G20, still we are facing a lot of pressure from the US and the Western countries, okay, to outrightly criticize Russia, but we are not doing so. But right now, Indonesia is in this kind of a situation. So guys, right, it is option E, recover together, recover stronger. Okay, so there is one more insight given by Shwetang, that Indonesia is also planning to buy oil from Russia via India. So again, this would put India in a very strategic position. Okay, because Southeast Asian countries are looking to India for defense purchases. Like Philippines has already booked the order for BrahMos. Okay, many countries are also looking the opportunity for buying the defense goods. Now, if Indonesia does that, then also it will put India in a very strategic location, in a very strategic position. But again, that would also have its cons. India will have to face the repercussion or the retaliation from the Western world. Right now, we need US in order to cater or tackle China rather in the Indian Ocean region. We need France, we need UK for our defense diversification. So we cannot outrightly do that also. So that is a really very tricky situation for India's diplomacy at the moment. Now let's come back to our studies. How many countries have legalized the same-sex marriages as of December 2021? So again, in India, we do not have the legal status to the same-sex marriages, although Article 377 to hata hi diya gaya hai, but still, same-sex marriages are not legalized. They are not endorsed by the legal system or the judiciary of India, because they think that this kind of a marriage is not fit for the Indian culture, and the Indian population is not in the mindset to endorse this kind of a decision. However, the court also needs to think about it, that it is first the legal authority that needs to endorse this thing, and only then the people will follow the suit. Because in child marriages also, the people were not ready to abolish this practice of child marriage, but still we took the decisions, although we may see this evil practice being practiced by the people across the country, but still to a very limited extent. So obviously we need to legalize it first, and then we can expect the population of India to accept these kinds of marriages. But let's see what will happen. 30 countries, absolutely right. Can you tell me the latest one to legalize the same-sex marriage? This is your next question. Tell me the country which had legalized the same-sex marriage in December only. Because of that only, this question is here. So here you have the next question. What is the score of India in the World Press Freedom Index 2021? Very good. 46.56 is the right answer. What is the ranking of India, guys? Can you tell me? The rank is 142nd and Norway is the first country. Okay. This Scandinavian country has outperformed every other country. So a total of 180 countries were assessed. Do remember this fact as well. Which company has launched Nivesh Bima, a non-linked, non-participating individual saving life insurance plan? Now guys, one advice that I would like to give you all is that prepare what this non-linked, non-participating individual insurance plans are, okay? So because these remain in the news off and on, so please remember to cover this concept thoroughly after this session, okay? This is the homework that I'm giving you all. Now tell me which company has launched this Nivesh Bima. Aviva is the right answer. Good. When is the National Energy Conservation Day observed? It's December 14. Yes, Vaibhav. Okay, very good. So I've got the answers. Chile is the country that had legalized the same-sex marriage in December 2021. And with Chile taking that decision, the total number of countries that have legalized the same-sex marriage is 30. Okay, in the world. Who has been appointed as a brand ambassador of Disney Baijus Early Learn application? Yes, Neeraj Chopra, PV Sindhu, both are the medal winners in Olympics 2020. Okay. Which company is establishing India's first green hydrogen based energy storage project? Okay, so right now what we are doing planning to achieve, first of all, we are planning to achieve the production of green energy, okay, green hydrogen, okay. Now what is green hydrogen? The electrolysis of water should be done by using the renewable energy sources. That would make the production of hydrogen completely green, okay, sustainable, because we are using renewable energy to produce another form of renewable energy. Secondly, we are aiming to have storage facility for the green energy. So it is not only in the terms of hydrogen energy, we are also striving to have the storage capacity for the solar energy as well. So basically we are trying to have ACC, advanced chemistry cells in India, build more and more advanced chemistry cells and have local manufacturing units for these cells, because these cells can store the renewable energy in the form of chemical energy, so, and it can later be turned into electrical energy. So for this only we have one scheme, that is production linked incentive scheme. Now since this topic is here, so let me tell you, PLI schemes are really important. Do not skip it, okay? We have provided you a separate document for all the PLIs. So cover the PLIs thoroughly, follow them, follow the spotlight and follow the recent updates regarding the PLI, because many companies are getting approval under so-and-so PLI scheme, okay? So that is also important for you. Okay, so that was all that I wanted to tell you. Now let me see what are the answers. Good. NTPC is the right answer. Which state has the highest employability as per the India Skills Report 2022? Yes, Shwetank. Nitin Gadkari drove India's first hydrogen car. Can you tell me the name of that car? Particular name is given to the car. Yes, 13 sectors mein PLI scheme is there. Maharashtra is the right answer. Good. With which company has ISRO signed an MOU for boosting research on NavIC messaging service? So this is our own GPS that we are developing, GPS like software that we are developing. Very good. Toyota Maria. Marai is the basically name of the Mirai. First hydrogen vehicle. Oppo. Good. Which country is the chair of Council of Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure of SCO? So guys, I have already told you this thing many times that SCO operates at three level. It has three main bodies. First is the heads of state council. Another one is head of government council. And we have the Council of Foreign Ministers. Okay. So these are the three main bodies of the SCO. But apart from these three functional bodies of SCO, there is another body that is Council of Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure, which is again an important organization of SCO. Okay. So which country has got the chairmanship of this council? That is the question. Very good. India is the right answer. So this makes this question all the more important. Also remember, Iran has got the permanent membership of SCO recently, okay, in the recent months, and it became the ninth member of SCO. Apart from this, dialogue members and new observer states were also added, and this is your task to prepare the members of SCO along with the other facts associated with SCO. Okay. Who is the Indian permanent ambassador to the UN? I guess it is a very basic question. All of you must know the answer of this question. So guys, it is T.S. Tirumurthy, and he has given a very, we can say, very useful statements on the Russia-Ukraine conflict and India's stand on it. So after this session, if you get time, if you are tired of your studies, then you must study his comments, okay, because he is the India's permanent ambassador to the UN. So what has he said, it is important for you to know, because his explanation on this issue is what the government thinks, is what the government wants to portray to the world. So do read it, because the Russia-Ukraine conflict and its impact on India may become a very crucial question in your interviews, and you may also see a question on this in your ESI paper, because the Russia-Ukraine crisis is having a lot of impact on the Indian economy. You can clearly see the prices of petrol, diesel rising to the sky. Okay, plus we are having inflation. We are having diplomatic pressure. Okay. So all of these reasons make India-Russia conflict more and more important. And secondly, and the most important thing, is the de-dollarization drive that the world is right now facing. Okay. So this is also there. Prepare on this de-dollarization as well. Which country has implemented the zero COVID policy? China. Absolutely right. Hong Kong, basically the special autonomous region of China. What is the venue of 7th edition of India International Science Festival? So guys, Panaji, Goa is the right answer. What is the theme of India Mobile Congress 2021? connectivity for the next decade is the right answer. Which bank has won the Digidhan Award from the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology? Karnataka Bank, guys, is the right answer. And this is the last question. So your wait is over now. Who has won the Ramanujan Prize for Young Mathematicians from Developing Countries in 2021? So guys, Neena Gupta is the right answer. Can you tell me the upper age limit for the candidates to apply for this award? Tell me the upper age limit. And guys, now since we have completed our session, we have completed the questions, you are very welcome. You are free to ask your queries. So if you have any query, ask me. It's 45 years of age is the upper limit for applying for this prize that is given by India to the mathematicians from developing nations. So that necessarily involves the mathematicians who are working in other countries. Okay, so it does not mean that the people in India would only get this Ramanujan prize. So we have completed the session. Now if you have any kind of doubt in preparation in anything, or if you want me to explain the strategy again, I can do so for you all. So tell me, what is it that you want to discuss with me? In my opinion, 3 to 4 hours would be the max. So this is the question by Anjali Kumari. What is the ideal time that we are required to give towards GA on a daily basis? So in my opinion, don't give more than 3 to 4 hours of your day to GK, because you have other things also to cover. And whenever you cover for RBI, you prepare for any examination, the approach should be to prepare phase 2 first and then phase 1. Although I'm not saying that you should leave the phase 1 and start preparing for phase 2. No, I'm not saying that. Right now you need to focus on the phase 1 only. But my point here is that do not spend a lot of time on one subject only, because you have other things to do as well. Now, one more thing that I want to state here, that guys, please do not feel agitated if you are not able to complete the spotlight in 3 to 4 hours, okay? Because everyone has his or her speed. Even if you are not able to complete the 45 to 50 pages in 3 to 4 hours, so what is the thing that you need to do? Wake up early in the day and start preparing, okay? So make out more and more time, pull out more and more time from your day, and then prepare. Don't give negative reinforcement to yourself that you are not able to do this. Do not let the self-doubt engulf you. That is my motto. Aishna Bansal, so on 3rd May, you are going to get your April spotlight session, and regarding that, you don't have to worry about it, because I am going to provide you with the April month's daily current affairs, okay? And daily current affairs are always very beneficial in comparison to the monthly PDFs. Why? Because you are getting it daily, one thing. Secondly, you are getting them in a very small quantity, right? So daily current affairs se padhte raho till 30th of April, and this will also help you in memorizing the April spotlight, because as I told you that the spotlight of 4 months prior to the examination are of utmost importance. So April ki spotlight aapko yaad karne mein bhi aasani hogi if you prepare it through the daily current affairs. So from where will you get the daily current affairs? So guys, you can get the daily current affairs from our website, okay? currentaffairs.anujindal.in. So I'm writing it here so that you can use this website. Okay, so Pratishtha Singh is asking, can we cover GA from daily spotlight? Yes, of course, daily se karo, lekin abhi kya hai ki aapke paas abhi hai 2nd April. ओके सो यू हैव स्पॉटलाइट टिल द मंथ ऑफ फेब्रवरी. मार्च की स्पॉटलाइट यू विल गेट इन द कमिंग मंथ्स. सो यू हैव एम्पल टाइम टू प्रिपेयर डिसम्बर जनवरी एंड फेब्रवरी स्पॉटलाइट इन दिस टाइम. देन यू विल गेट द मार्च स्पॉटलाइट. सो दीज फोर मंथ्स आई वुड रिकमेंड यू ऑल टू प्रिपेयर फ्रॉम द स्पॉटलाइट मैगजीन. फॉर अप्रैल एंड मे वॉट यू कैन डू प्रिपेयर फ्रॉम द डेली करंट अफेयर्स डॉक्यूमेंट्स. ओके बिकॉज अगेन आई वुड से कि अप्रैल और मई में आपके बहुत एक क्रूशियल करंट अफेयर्स होते हैं तो वो कुछ भी पूछ लेते हैं आपको. ठीक है तो देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स दैट आर और दैट आर ऑफ नॉट वेरी मच ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंस. देयरफॉर आई टेंड टू डिडक्ट दैट फ्रॉम द मंथली मैगजीन. ओके सो यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट टू रीड दैट फ्रॉम द डेली करंट अफेयर्स PDF ऑल्सो. Anshul Agarwal is asking me for working aspirants what is the ideal time for spotlight. Guys, understand this thing that it depends upon you. How much time are you taking? Suppose there is a person who has very sharp reading skills. So that person would be able to cover the spotlight in a very quick time, maybe 1 hour or 2 hours or so. But if there is a person who has very sharp mathematical or very sharp numerical skills, but he is not very much willing to read the theory, he or she has a very less interest in theory, so that person may take 3 to 4 hours. Okay, so it depends completely on you. So if you are a working aspirant, take out your time, analyze yourself that how many hours am I taking in covering 30 to 40 pages of spotlight. But one thing that I can surely say is that you need to stay honest with yourself, okay? Because you are not cheating anyone else, you are cheating yourself if you are not preparing thoroughly, okay? So we have told you to prepare 45 pages one day. So that is something, that is the target that you should aim to achieve. But again, I would say don't let the negative thoughts engulf you if you are not able to achieve it. So try to have more and more time devoted to that. Okay. Of course, Vishika, this is a very important question. So Vishika has asked me that do you need to memorize the events, the venue of the international events like G20 summits for 23, 24 and the years so on. Of course, they can very well be asked in the examination. Pooja, there is no very clear demarcation provided by RBI. As per the past years, there were questions from appointments, awards. However, it is not likely that you will have almost 10 to 12 questions from awards or from appointments. It is not going to happen. You may have 1 to 2 questions, but those 1 to 2 questions are also very important because they are going to fetch you marks that may push you forward in comparison to the other candidates. So do not let even 1 mark of your go. Okay, don't let it go. Manish Nayak is asking me that whether it is important for going through the daily current affairs video. So let me tell you that many students adopt this approach to watch the videos first and then they move on to the daily current affairs document. Okay, but there is a certain lot of people who prefer the monthly current affairs document only. Okay, and they prefer to watch the monthly revision sessions like I have taken right now. Okay, now I am a person who would prefer daily documents. Okay, I am a person who would prefer daily videos because daily karenge, consistently karenge, to thode mein hi zyada ho jayega, right? There are certain people who are of very high intellectual capacity that they can read monthly documents and they can grasp all what is there in the monthly document. And they watch the monthly sessions and they are able to get through the examination. One more benefit of monthly document is that you get everything summarized, okay, at one place. So you don't have to go and look for the theme of certain event in another document or associated fact of the event in the other documents of the same month, because you are going to get it summarized at one place. So it is totally up to you. It is nothing like that we can advise you what is the best method for you. But right now, as I have already told you that December, Jan and Feb and March, these 4 months prepare from the spotlight. Okay? And for April to May, you can prepare from the daily current affairs document. Okay? So this is my advice for you all. Vibhav Jain is asking me, is it fine for the candidates to leave RBI and PIB 247 if they are covering Spotlight magazine? देखो, Spotlight आपकी phase one के लिए ही बनाई गई है for RBI, SEBI and NABARD. So obviously it is very aptly prepared. So you can definitely use it as your base source. If you get time, in my opinion, you should also prepare to PIB 247 and RBI 247. Now, how can you prepare it if you haven't touched it even before this session or before the 1st of April? So then you can use the sessions that we are going to conduct on our YouTube channel. Okay? So use those sessions because अगर नहीं अभी नहीं पढ़ोगे तो आपको फेज टू के लिए तो पढ़ना ही है. एंड फॉर फेज टू यू आर नॉट गेटिंग 2 to 3 months, यू आर जस्ट गेटिंग 1 month. सो योर फेज टू एग्जामिनेशन इज इन जून एंड May 28 इज योर फेज 1 एग्जामिनेशन. ओके? सो इन माई ओपिनियन फर्स्ट कवर द स्पॉटलाइट थरली, डोंट कॉम्प्रोमाइज विद दिस. देन इफ यू गेट टाइम वॉच द सेशंस दैट मनीष सर इज गोइंग टू कंडक्ट ऑन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल फ्रॉम द PIB 247 एंड फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स. नाउ गवर्नमेंट स्कीम का सेशन तो गाइज आपको करना ही है बिकॉज इट इज रियली 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 इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके? आई हैव अटैच्ड टू मैनी रियली टू इट, सो इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो आई हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो फॉर PIB 247 मनीष सर इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू गिव यू द राइट काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रैटेजी. हाउ कैन यू प्रिपेयर? ओके, द बेसिक स्ट्रैटेजी टू कवर एनी बुक एनी सब्जेक्ट इज टू हैव द टोटल नंबर ऑफ पेजेस दैट यू आर सपोज टू कवर, देन डिवाइड देम विद 30 days और 40 days, वट एवर इज योर टारगेट, एंड देन सी हाउ मेनी पेजेस आर यू नीड टू cover in just one day. That is the basic strategy that I opt for many of the subjects. So you can also do that. Okay, so Priyanka Yadav is asking me, PLI scheme is very vast. What should be the key data to be remembered from PLI? So देखो, government schemes में कोई भी आपका key data नहीं होता है क्योंकि सारा ही data बहुत key होता है. समझ रहे हैं आप लोग? वो ऐसा क्यों करते हैं? क्योंकि आप जो की डेटा है वो तो सभी याद करके जा रहे हैं. डिफरेंस क्या है? तभी तो SSC जैसे एग्जाम में सबके 100+ मार्क्स आते हैं. कैसे आ रहे हैं? वो इसीलिए आ रहे हैं क्योंकि जो की डेटा है वो सब याद करके जा रहे हैं. तो आपको जो है सब कुछ ही याद करना पड़ेगा तभी आपका निकल पाएगा. आई नो इट इज़ रियली वास्ट, बट वॉट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन प्रिपेयर द निमोनिक्स, योर यू कैन प्रिपेयर द एक्रोनिम्स फॉर द वास्ट इंफॉर्मेशन in accordance with your preferences. Okay, whatever you like. Some people like to create stories out of the information and then they remember it better, and some people like to create mnemonics or acronyms for memorizing the big information. So whatever is preferable to you, you can do that. Aishla, I'm not saying that you can replace the daily current affairs with spotlight. अगर आपको spotlight से पढ़ने की आदत है तो ये तो बहुत ही अच्छी बात है. आप spotlight से पढ़ो, कोई नहीं कह रहा आपको कि आप daily current affairs से पढ़ो. मैं बस इतना कह रही हूँ कि daily current affairs के document आपके April और May के daily ही जा रहे हैं, तो जब तक आपको spotlight नहीं मिल जाती है तब तक आप daily पढ़ो इनसे. ठीक है? I'm just saying that. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट आपको मंथली से पढ़ने की आदत है तो आप अप्रैल का डेली ही पढ़िए, मंथली से मत पढ़िए. डेली पढ़िए और जब मंथली आएगा तो मंथली से आपका रिवाइज हो जाएगा. इट विल बी अ टाइम सेवर फॉर यू. गणेश बंसोड़े इज आस्किंग मी अबाउट दी सिडबी करंट अफेयर्स. सो गणेश, आई हैव सीन द सिडबी नोटिफिकेशन. So in there, the banking and finance news was given privilege, and then the economy related news was also given privilege. Now banking finance में तो आपका spotlight में specific section है ही, but economy में economy is a vast concept that may also include your government schemes, the schemes like national monetization plan that also aims to build the infrastructure that will have a multiplier impact on the economy. So in this manner you have to broaden your mind, and the one suggestion that I can give you is that you can prepare from spotlight. Okay, spotlight is designed in that manner only. No, Prachi, please don't do this mistake, and I'm saying this to everyone. Prachi is asking me that whether she needs to pick up another source for topics. So here, no is the answer. No, don't keep many sources, because this is the very crucial time you will get confused. Keep one source as your base. Okay, now is not the time to experiment. It is the time to work hard. Don't change your strategy. If you are Aishna, if you are able to prepare from the monthly current affairs magazine, if you are accustomed to do that, so do it from there only. Don't change your strategy. That was just an advice from my side. Shruti is asking about the PLI schemes video. Yes, of course, there is a video on PLI schemes. That is, these PLI schemes are covered in the PIB 247 sessions. Okay, and let's see if we get the time from our timetable that we have provided to you. If we get time, then we will create a special session on PLI schemes as well. Okay, but that is something that is to be seen with time, because right now we are running on a very tight schedule, guys. So, but we will definitely try to keep one session on. Dinesh, the videos of Daily Current Affairs are premiered at 9 p.m., not 7 a.m. now. कौशिक सिडबी के लिए भी आप देख सकते हैं ये सेशंस जो हम कर रहे हैं अभी मंथली के लिए, ठीक है, क्योंकि करंट अफेयर्स तो सेम ही है ना. अब अगर कोई स्कीम लॉन्च हो रही है तो ऐसा तो नहीं है वो स्कीम सिर्फ आरबीआई में ही पूछी जाएगी, वो कहीं भी पूछ सकते हैं. तो करंट अफेयर्स आर सेम. ओके, सो यू कैन यूज द सेशंस दैट आई एम टेकिंग राइट नाउ फॉर योर सिडबी एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल. Anshul, this very question, I have already provided you the answer of this in our course. So Anshul Agarwal is asking that can we get the consolidated exercise document of exercises that India conduct with other nations. So yes, I have provided you India's joint military exercises document. Okay, and there is a session also on YouTube. You can search for my session on the joint military exercises that India conduct with other nations. Okay, it is basically the static GK section in which I have covered other facts as well. So you can search it on YouTube. I took it when SEBI examination was there. So you will get there the list of all the exercises. Arnab Chakrabarti, if I have told you already, how many times do I suppose to tell you? I have already told you ki if you are comfortable in covering the spotlight, cover it from there. And I have already told you that December to March, cover it from spotlight. And April to May, cover it from daily current affairs. And for those students who are accustomed to spotlight, so cover them from spotlight. No, Abhishek Tripathi, don't spend time on covering the spotlight of 1 year. 6 months are enough. Okay? Not 1 year. 6 months are enough. If you want, guys, I will share this PDF also. Okay? So, a lot of questions are there. प्रज्ञा कंदारी इज आस्किंग मी इज देयर एनी वे वी शुड प्रायोरिटाइज अ सर्टन सेट ऑफ अ मंथ स्पॉटलाइट लाइक इंटरनेशनल न्यूज नेशनल न्यूज एक्सेट्रा. सो हियर माई आंसर टू यू इज दैट स्पॉटलाइट को पहले तो जो आपके 6 months की स्पॉटलाइट है उसको प्रायोरिटाइज करो. उसमें से आपके जो 4 months जस्ट प्रिसीडिंग द एग्जामिनेशन है उसको प्रायोरिटाइज करो लाइक योर मे अप्रैल मार्च फेब. अब आती है बात स्पॉटलाइट के सेक्शंस की, तो आप किन सेक्शंस को प्रायोरिटाइज करोगे. इन माय ओपिनियन ऑल आर प्रायोरिटीज, किसी में से भी कुछ भी आ जाता है. स्पेशली आई हैव सीन द टेंडेंसी इन स्टूडेंट्स दैट दे टेंड टू इग्नोर सर्टेन सेक्शंस लाइक स्पोर्ट्स अवार्ड्स मिसलेनियस लाइक द पीपल हु हैव डाइड और द बुक्स दैट हैव बीन पब्लिश्ड और देर आर सर्टेन पीपल हु टेंड टू इग्नोर इम्पॉर्टेंट डेज और अवार्ड्स. सो अवार्ड्स तो मैंने लिख दिया है, स्पोर्ट्स भी हो गया है. चलिए ठीक है, तो ये जो 4 sections है दे आर द वेरी लाइट सेक्शंस इन कंपेरिजन टू योर नेशनल और योर बैंकिंग सेक्शन. देर यू हैव अ लॉट ऑफ न्यूज़ बट इन दीज सेक्शंस यू हैव कंपेरेटिवली वेरी लेस न्यूज़. सो वाई टू इग्नोर दीज सेक्शंस. इन माई ओपिनियन ऑल दीज सेक्शंस आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. देर इज नो नीड टू प्रायोरिटाइज एनी वन सेक्शन. However, it's just your hard work. So in national and international news, you may have to put in a lot of effort because the news are huge. And in comparison to that effort, in sports, awards, miscellaneous and other sections, you may have a less amount of effort. But priority to aapko sabhi ko deni padegi. वैभव त्यागी, वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मेकिंग क्रिस्प नोट्स फ्रॉम करंट अफेयर्स आई हैव जस्ट गिवन यू व्हेन आई कवर्ड दी ADB लोन, एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक लोन. ओके, आई टोल्ड यू हाउ कैन यू प्रिपेयर द लोन, जस्ट राइट डाउन द नेम ऑफ द स्टेट. ओके, देन यू कैन राइट डाउन द रीजन, यू कैन राइट डाउन द अमाउंट. नाउ इफ यू मेक इट इन अ टेब्यूलर फॉर्म देन यू विल बी एबल टू मेमोराइज इट बेटर. सो वन एडवाइस टू यू ऑल इज टू मेक योर नोट्स विजुअली अट्रैक्टिव. ओके, टू योर सेल्फ कंसाइज होने चाहिए, काफ़ी कम शब्द का यूज होना चाहिए, कंसाइज. ठीक है, लेस एंड लेस वर्ड्स, मोर फैक्ट्स. फैक्टशीट क्रिएट करिए अपनी खुद की एंड पेस्ट योर फैक्टशीट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑन द वॉल एंड हैव अ कॉन्टिन्यूस लुक एट दैट फैक्टशीट. ओके, सो बाय मेकिंग विजुअली अट्रैक्टिव नोट्स आई मीन टू से यूज टेबल्स, यूज ग्राफ्स दैट यू कैन योर सेल्फ ड्रॉ बिकॉज यू कैन यूज दोज ग्राफ्स इन योर ESI आंसर राइटिंग ऑल्सो. राइट, मतलब हैबिट डेवलप हो जाएगी आपकी. हालांकि आपका राइटिंग का पेपर रिटर्न नहीं होता है, ऑफलाइन नहीं होता है, ऑनलाइन होता है, आई नो दैट, बट स्टिल इफ यू डू दिस प्रैक्टिस दिस विल ब्रॉडन योर माइंड सेट. एंड इफ यू डोंट हैव टाइम यू डोंट नीड टू डू दिस एक्सरसाइज एट ऑल. बट द वे यू कैन मेक योर नोट्स इज दैट टेबल बना के कर सकते हो आप, और आप अलग अलग पेन का यूज कर सकते हो टू हाईलाइट सर्टन फैक्ट्स. एंड आप जैसे अगर कुछ इंडिया रिलेटेड फैक्ट है, फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट मध्य प्रदेश, देर इज अ न्यूज अबाउट मध्य प्रदेश, सो यू कैन ड्रॉ इंडियाज मैप लाइक दिस. ओके, बहुत गंदी ड्राइंग हो गई, बट कोई नहीं, आप लोगों की ड्राइंग अच्छी होगी, आई नो. सो मध्य प्रदेश के बारे में अगर कोई न्यूज़ है, सो यू कैन जस्ट ड्रॉ लाइक दिस एंड यू कैन राइट द फैक्ट. ओके, MP भोपाल, ठीक है, भोपाल न्याय योजना, समथिंग लाइक दिस. ठीक है, ऐसे कुछ कर सकते हैं आप, इससे आपको ज्यादा याद रहेगा. ओके, सो इट्स 8 AM नाउ गाइज, आई थिंक. सो ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू वाइंड अप दिस सेशन बिकॉज राइट नाउ एट 8 PM वी आर गोइंग टू हैव आस्क मी एनीथिंग सेशन बाय अनुज सर. सो दैट ऑल्सो यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेरीज टू हिम. सो थैंक यू सो मच गाइज, यू हैव बीन रियली गुड इन द सेशन. थैंक यू, एंड यू हैव टू कम फॉर दी अनदर सेशन ऑन 5th April फॉर December Part 2. थैंक यू सो मच.